this is Sue Aston and welcome to my Diary of a Coastal Composer show. So this week's show, I'm going to be talking a little bit to you about my new piece, Mizzling Marsh, and I'm going to be playing you what I've got so far. And the weather in Cornwall's been typical August weather. It's been like the monsoon season. We've had lots of really torrential rain, which is quite thrilling. And I'm going to show you a piece of artwork that was inspired by that kind of weather in the middle of August. It's a little drawing, little kind of watercolour sketch that I did of a misty boat at Malpas, which is near Truro in Cornwall. And I'm going to finish off by reading to you from my blog. So I'm going to play you a little bit of my piece called Mizzling Marsh, so that you can hear how it's coming along. I've been working on a very small introduction to the piece, which I kind of got the introduction from the very first melody line. And I'm kind of working on a middle section, which I'm not going to play yet, because it's still work in progress. But I'll also play you another little section that you haven't heard before. And you might recognise kind of the feel of it, because it kind of links to my piece called November Skies, because it's the same kind of inspiration behind this piece, and that's kind of like Marazine Marsh and the Starling Murmurations, so you might kind of notice it's got a similar feel to it. Anyway, here goes. Watercolour sketch that I made a couple of years ago in August, and I was sitting in the car at Boscawen Park overlooking the river near Malpas, and there was a little red boat that caught my eye, and it looked quite sorry for itself, really. It was kind of all on its own. And I was sheltering in the car from the rain and surrounded by trees. And so this is my little watercolour sketch. And you can see that I tried to capture a lonely little sailing boat. And you can see the reds of the boat kind of all misty and reflected in the river. And the tree was a very welcome place to have a little bit of shelter. So yeah, I love going and sitting in my car, even if the weather's bad, and just getting my portable watercolour paints out and just trying to capture what I see, really. It's another little snapshot. It's a bit like my music. It's kind of like, it all becomes a diary. Like, the music reminds me of what I was doing on a particular day, or a location that inspired it. And in the same way, I have my little paint box with me to try and capture a moment in time. And you just look at the painting and then listen to the music, and that little moment in time all comes flooding back. So hope you enjoyed my little painting. So I'm going to read you an extract from my blog called Reflections at Malpas. Another day of humid rain. It's late August and I feel sorry for any holiday makers, especially if they are camping. I sit under a tree at Boscawen Park and paint another rainy, boaty picture. Holiday makers lured here with the hope of sun and Poldark scything will be disappointed. But I am not. I love the rain. Bad weather is my friend and is a source of comfort to me. Good job. The days are not as long as they were, but still humid. I'm longing now for autumn. Darker days when I can sit at the piano without distraction. Just fluid days which ease into the evenings. Days of piano melodies and naps. Music comes to me when I sleep. And I sleep a lot. On days like this, sometimes the weather may clear, as it did last night. By tea time, the skies were luminous, and we took a moonlit walk from Pendine Lighthouse to Portheris Cove. The sea was black as squid ink, the rocks as deep a hue as coal, yet the sky and sand appeared illuminated. As we returned to our car, the lighthouse was sending out its ray of penetrating light out to sea, picking out the gulls in the sky as they dipped and hovered. The sound of bellowing bulls from a nearby field punctuated the night. A perfect evening, dark and brimming with solace, heightened by the thrill of zero petrol in our tank as we drove home. So I hope you enjoyed my show, and we're hoping as the weather clears up that we might get an Indian summer in Cornwall. So as we head towards the autumn, we're going to do some shots outside, and you can come with me on some of my favourite walks and enjoy a journey through the landscape of Cornwall. So special thanks goes to Edna, Jenny, Paolo and all my patrons. And if you'd like to sponsor my work as a composer, please do head over to patreon.com/SueAston. And please do check out my music on SueAston.com. Thank you and see you soon.